Please stand for the Pledge of Allegiance.
I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Good morning, Hopewell. I'm your host, Roman Schutter, and I'm bringing you this week's Morning Buzz. Today is Friday, March 10th, and today is an A Day. Next week's focus for Disability Awareness Month will be on physical disabilities. A physical disability is a condition that limits one or more basic physical activities in life, such as walking, climbing, stairs, reaching, carrying, or lifting. These limitations hinder the person from performing tasks for daily living. Listen to the morning announcements next week to find out more. Kira is up next, bringing you the Addams Family.
Hi, I'm Kira, and today I'm going to tell you about the Addams Family. This eccentric fam was created in 1938 by Charles Addams in a series of single-panel cartoons. The characters consist of Gomez and Morticia, their kids Wednesday and Pugsley, Uncle Fester, Grandmama, their butler Lurch, Cousin It, Thing, and various pets. This clan comes from old money and resembles the ideal American family, except for the fact that they love all that is grim and disturbing.
The Addams Family challenged middle-class suburbia, criticizing it for its lack of tolerance and individuality.
The original show ran for 2 seasons, followed by a telefilm. Their first animated appearance was actually in Scooby-Doo, and then they got an animated series of their own. The craze picked up again in the 90s with a live-action film, inspiring another animated series, and later its sequel, which introduces their new son, Pubert. Next came a reboot film and another TV series. After a 20-year break, an animated film was produced in 2019, and its sequel 2 years later. The newest work with this family was the Netflix series Wednesday. And in addition to everything else I've said, there have been video games, a pinball machine, books, comic books, appearances in ads, an attempted variety show, a musical adaptation, and soundtrack albums. Throughout its many iterations, the franchise has become a staple of pop culture and an inspiration for goth subculture. And no matter which version you prefer, I think it's very cool to see how these beloved characters grew and adapted across generations and into new popular types of media. Thanks for watching, and go see The Wedding Singer.
Great job, Kara. Now we send things off to Iris, who will be talking about bikes.
Biking.
One of the gnarliest forms of kinesthetic self-expression. Because my bike was stolen and I can bike with no hands, I'm basically an expert on the thing. Statistically, the BMX is the third sickest ride behind the motorcycle and Heely. It's the fun uncle to the road bike because it gives riders more freedom and creativity. Not only can BMXers choreograph their stunts, they can also transform the streets or wilderness into rideable terrains, thus repurposing industrialized landscapes like cities. The King of New York showcases these talents in Tompkins Square Park.
A bike similar to how Froma used like a beat machine, or how somebody may use a mic and paint this picture.
The street riding force is highly contested, and bikers debate if BMX culture is about the development of tricks, or if the obstacles and rules being generated around them constrict freedom while freestyling. Our very own biking scene here at HVS spends their time outdoors. They're not motorized, but they sure can fly.
Faster!
My advice to you is stay cool, stay bike.
Thanks, Iris. Athletic training isn't always about sports. Here's more about performance training.
Ow, I hurt my leg.
Somebody get Peter. Hey everyone, what happened? Are you okay?
I hurt my leg.
All right, we're gonna do a body mechanic assessment back at my room. So we're gonna take her back to my room.
As you can see, Peter was quick to the scene and was ready to treat Chelsea. It is essential to have an athletic trainer in the performing art environment because athletic trainers help to decrease the risk of injury and are specialized in treating vocalists and other performers. Athletic trainers are in charge of body mechanic assessments, wrapping, and recovery movements.
A body mechanic assessment helps athletic trainers to find where the pain and injury is and treat it from there. Wrapping will aid in prevention and reduce swelling, while recovery movements allow from an athletic to heal over time. Athletic trainers are here to help and are essential. Thank your athletic trainer the next time you see them and for all the help they give you to allowing to get back to sports faster.
We had the wrestling team on our Captain's Crunch segment a few weeks ago, and there were some controversial statements.
My favorite memory was taking down Mr. Geis in practice.
We have a retraction for you.
My favorite moment was when I dreamt about taking down Geis in practice. It never happened, and I fully admit that, but I can surely dream about it.
Some interesting developments right there. Now, here's another message from the student council.
This week's rivalry is between our two beefing gym teachers, Vina and Ashman. Neither of them want to lose, but the say over who gets pied in the face is left up to you. This month is a spring pep rally, so it's time to start getting excited now.
Now it's time for the movie mystery.
Is he guilty or not guilty?
Ah! I want nothing!
He's our son.
Ah! 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 No! Don! Don! Stop!
Last week's movie mystery was Scooby-Doo.
You're in trouble. Oh boy.
That's all for today, Hopewell. See you later.